Welcome to IT Free Training. In this video, I will look at automating the importing and exporting of users in Active Directory. The video will look at two command line tools provided by Microsoft called CSVDE and LDIFDE. If you have a scenario in your workplace where you need to create a large number of users very quickly, these tools become invaluable. For example, if you work in an educational institution, there may be a need to create a large number of new users at enrollment time. In the workplace, you may need to migrate a large number of users from one system to another system. Using automated tools like the ones described in this video makes the process a lot faster. I will begin by starting with the CSVDE, followed by LDIFDE. The fundamental difference between the two tools is the format the tools use to import and export data. CSVDE uses comma-delimited files that are compatible with software like Excel. LDIFDE uses the lightweight directory access protocol data interchange format, otherwise known as LDIF. Using the LDIF format, you can export Active Directory users and import them into other non-Active Directory-based systems. To start with, I will look at the CSVDE tool. First of all, I will open a command prompt from the Start menu. The CSVDE tool has quite a few options, so I will only go through the most commonly used options. For a complete list of the options, see the link in the description for this video. I will now perform an export to give you a better understanding of the CSV format the tool uses. Once the data has been exported, the CSV file can be opened in Excel or Notepad. To perform the export, this is done with the -F parameter, followed by the file name. In this case, I will call it output.ad.csv. There are not too many objects in this domain, so the process will not take too long. Once complete, I can now open Windows Explorer and see the export file. Since I have Excel installed on this computer, I can double-click the file to open it in Excel. Here you can see all the data that was exported. If I scroll to the right, you will notice that there are lots of columns of data. If you are importing this data on another system, you may be able to import the data file as is without any modification. CSVDE can also be used to import data. If I scroll back to the start, I will find many of the columns are not required when creating new accounts. Therefore, I will delete the extra columns and the unwanted data from the file. When creating a new account, in many cases you will just want basic information such as the username, first and last name of the new user. Once I have removed the extra data and columns, I will be left with 6 columns. This provides the basic attributes for the user accounts that I want to create. I can now enter in the details for 3 user accounts that I want to create. Most attributes are fairly simple to understand. Object class is the type of object you want to create, in this case, a user. The SAM account name is the username used with operating systems before Windows 2000. SN for the surname, given name for the first name, and the user principal name, the Windows login name, in email-style format. The first column, DN, contains the distinguished name for the object, which allows you to specify the domain and organizational unit the object will be created in. Once you are happy with the data in the Excel spreadsheet, select the option Save As. In this case, I will save the file as input.ad, so the original output AD is preserved. When saving the file, you should ensure that the type is CSV, comma delimited. If you save the file in another format, CSVDE will not be able to read the file. Excel will prompt you, telling that if you save the file in this format, you will lose any features that are not supported in this file format. For our requirements, this is fine, so I will press Yes. If I now go back to Windows Explorer, if I right-click on the file and select Open With, I can select Notepad to open the file. Notice that the file is a text-based file, so I could have created the file with Notepad, or this file could have been exported using third-party software or scripts. If I now go back to the command prompt, I can import this file by running CSVDE minus I for import and minus F followed by the file name. Once the command has run, notice that I get a message saying that there was an error. The problem was that one of the users in the file already exists. When CSVDE encounters an error, it will exit. To get around this, you can add the minus K option. This will tell CSVDE to ignore errors and continue processing. When I run the command again with the minus K parameter, notice that the error indicating the user already exists will be reported again. This time, the command will process all the users in the file and not stop when it encounters an error. This covers how to use the CSVDE tool. The next tool that I will look at is LDIFDE. Although LDIFDE exports data in a different format, the parameters for CSVDE and LDIFDE are the same. If I open the command prompt again, as with the last command, I will need to run LDIFDE with the parameter minus F followed by the file name. This will export all the objects from Active Directory into a file in LDIF format. Now that the data has been exported, I will go back to Windows Explorer and open the file. When asked, I will select Notepad to open the file when prompted. Notice that the file is text-based, like the CSV file. However, the format of the file is very different. You can see at the top the attribute DN. Any third-party directory system that supports this format will be able to read this file and make use of the data. To import the file with LDIFDE, just like CSVDE, you use the parameter minus I. Normally, you would not import the same data that you just exported in the same domain, but for the purpose of the demonstration, this is how you would import an LDIF file. Just like with the CSVDE command, you can add the minus K parameter, and this will ignore any errors that it finds and continue processing to the end of the file. This covers the CSVDE and LDIFDE tools. You can see that these tools can be used to automate the creation and migration of Active Directory objects in Windows and other systems. This video was provided by ITFreeTraining and is only one video in the free Active Directory course. Please see our website or YouTube channel for more free videos and courses. Thanks for watching.